Hi everybody, it's Dr. Shawn Talbott, MonaVie's Chief Science and Innovation Officer, and welcome to another edition of From the Lab. You know, one of the best parts about my job is not the science. One of the best parts about my job is the fact that I get to go out and talk to people a lot and hear, in their own words, what these products are doing for them. I get to hear people talk about how much weight they've lost and how much better they feel with our Reveal system. I get to hear from people about how more flexible they are and how much energy they have when they use our juices and our EMV products. Now I get to hear from people about how much lower their stress levels are and how they're sleeping better and waking up with more energy with our new stress products, Balance and Rest. But you know, it's great for me to hear all that kind of stuff, and it's great for people to come up to me and say, "Oh, Dr. Talbott, you have helped me in these particular ways," that I love to hear those kinds of things. But it's not just me, folks. We have a wonderful team of product development and R&D people here at the office within MonaVie, and we also have a worldwide network of scientific experts and organizations that really help us to think about these products, to come up with these ideas, to figure out a niche of product we need to go to, and then find natural options in the world to satisfy those needs, and also help us to do the research and do the education. It really is a what I call a matrix, where there's different people and different institutions with different expertise. So to give you an example of that, my PhD is in nutritional biochemistry. So when I look at a particular problem, I think about a solution with a particular set of toolbox. You know, I look at biochemistry, I look at nutrients, I look at foods, I look at whatever I look at. That's one perspective. We really need to develop the best solutions. We really need several perspectives all at the same time. And that's where our scientific advisory board comes in. I'm happy today to introduce you to our brand new global scientific advisory board. And what I want you to understand about it is that it's global in geography, because MonaVie is a global nutrition company now. MonaVie's around the world. We're not just a US company. We're not just a North American company. We have serious operations around the world. Japan, Brazil, Europe, Southeast Asia, all around the globe, and we need to have scientific representation there. But we also need to have representation around different areas of science. So I mentioned I'm a nutritional biochemist. That's one perspective. We also want to have other perspectives, and that's why we have the scientists on our scientific advisory board that we do. So let me introduce the first one, Dani Kwan, whose PhD is in pharmaceutics. Her particular area of expertise is in how do we deliver nutrients the most effectively. Something that you might know as the word bioavailability. How can we put things on our bodies topically and have them delivered effectively? How can we ingest nutrients and have them not just absorbed best, but absorbed and transported and delivered and retained in that target tissue? Dr. Kwan was very instrumental in helping us design the bioessence blends that we have in several of our MonaVie products. The most bioavailable carotenoid blends that you'll find in the market. We have very good research that you'll hear about in a future edition of From the Lab about how we put that formula together and the research that we've done to validate that superior bioavailability. So her PhD is in pharmaceutics, and that's a very different perspective from what I will have as a nutritional biochemist. We have another scientific advisory board member, Dr. Michael Balick, who is an ethnobotanist. And Mike is literally one of those kinds of guys who'll go into the jungle, and a month later will come stumbling out of the jungle with a root in his hand and say, "Here's the thing for that problem." Ethnobotany really is the study of plants and people. And so we look to ethnobotanists very often to find out, what did this culture do naturally to treat this condition, or to satisfy this problem, or to help people feel better in this particular way? Mike is a very, very good resource for helping us figure out what plants to use in what categories. In fact, I was just at one of his exhibits at the New York Botanical Garden that he curated, an exhibit called Wild Medicine, which was all about medicinal plants from around the world. And one of the things you may not know is that approximately 40% of all pharmaceuticals that are on the market had their origins at one point in a plant. So we're talking about a root or a leaf or a seed or a nut or a stem had some sort of a compound that was eventually developed into a pharmaceutical. And when you talk to someone like Mike, you know, you that kind of statistic comes up. Wow, 40% of all medicines came from the plant world. But then Mike knows enough about it to say, well, wait a minute, we've only really looked at about 2% of the entire plant kingdom to a degree of really medicinal chemistry. So, you know, I go to an exhibit like Wild Medicine, and I go through the 150 or so thousand square feet of medicinal palms and medicinal ferns and shrubs and things like that. And I literally get goosebumps thinking about the potential that's there, the potential that's in the jungle or that's in the rainforest or that's in the desert that we haven't even scratched the surface on yet, that we can eventually someday here at MonaVie come out with the next big thing, which is what gets us all up in the morning, and people like Danny Kwan, people like Mike Balick will be helping us do that. So we also have scientific representation from Dr. Jun Nishihira, who's our scientific advisory board member in Japan. His expertise is several-fold. He has an MD, so he's trained in medicine, and he has a PhD, and he studies a lot of sort of agricultural ways to help rebalance our bodies in terms of inflammation, in terms of oxidation, in terms of immune system function. So wide-ranging skills, all coming back to the idea of eating right, eating brightly colored fruits and vegetables. So he'll be instrumental in our Japan market, but also around the world in helping us to spread the message of eating right and what that does for your body, for your biochemistry, for your ultimate health. We also have a scientific advisory board member in Brazil, where the history of MonaVie started with the acai berry. Hervé Roger is a PhD in food science. His expertise centers on the acai, but also centers more broadly on polyphenol chemistry or flavonoid chemistry. He's a world-leading expert, not just in acai, but how to uniquely and most efficiently get the beneficial compounds out of that berry. You know, we know that berry is hundreds of different biological, bioactive compounds, and some of them are water-soluble flavonoids, some are fat-soluble flavonoids, some are these anti-inflammatory fatty acids. That's that little green sheen of oil that you see in our MonaVie products. So Dr. Roger is studying all of those aspects, how to use them totally, how to use them separately, how they interact with each other to deliver those wonderful health benefits of acai. So we're very excited to have him on our SAB, not just for the Brazil market, but really for what we're trying to do around the world. So those are the four individuals that we have on our scientific advisory board at this point. We are talking to several experts about adding them in different areas of expertise in different categories of products that we're going into in the future. So look for additional SAB members to be added in the future. But I also want to tell you about three new educational and research partnerships that we have ongoing. And the first one is with the American Institute for Stress, AIS. I'm a fellow of the American College, or the American Institute of Stress, and I've been working with them for years to educate the population about the detrimental health effects of chronic stress. So now we have a formal program with AIS where MonaVie and AIS will be working in conjunction to educate the media, educate health professionals, educate the population, not only about why stress is bad, but what you can do to help your body be more resilient in the face of stress. And so our new products are just the first step in that direction, MonaVie Balance and MonaVie Rest. Look for more in the stress category coming from this partnership in the coming weeks and months. We also have a research and education partnership with the International Society for Sport Nutrition. They're helping us develop what we're referring to right now as an active nutrition platform. You know, nutrition is something that is so central to our feeling of health and wellness and our ability to get up and go out there and do something. So we want people to think of nutrition not just for health, but for active health, for giving you the motivation to go out there and be active and actually do something with your life and do something with your body. So the ISSN will be very active in helping us determine what sort of products will be in an active nutrition line. It's something that we really want to take our existing success with the Reveal line and build on that in certain ways, so that we're not just talking about weight loss, we're talking about optimal nutrition throughout the entire lifespan. And our final research and education partnership that I can announce today is our partnership with the New York Botanical Garden. New York Botanical Garden is where Dr. Balick is the head of research, but the NYBG does so many important things around the idea of plants and people. They have maybe the largest botanical research center in the world in terms of figuring out what kinds of health benefits are in this plant, or how did this culture use these plants for health and well-being. And so we're very excited about supporting some of Dr. Balick's work, supporting some of his research, and supporting some of the outreach that the New York Botanical Garden does. So that's our new scientific advisory board. It represents MonaVie globally, it represents MonaVie in different scientific disciplines, and it represents MonaVie in different ways. So it's not just about the science, it's about how we can get that science and apply it in terms of education so that people have something they can use to make their lives more meaningful. That's what we're all about here at MonaVie. So this is Dr. Shawn Talbott. Thanks for joining me on this edition of From the Lab, and I'll see you next time. Don't forget to send in your questions so that we can answer them on future editions of From the Lab. Just send your emails to the address that you see at the bottom of the screen. Thanks.